Wow.
Are you a fish, Dee Dee?
Mm.
You're gonna tell everyone what you just did.
No, I'm not.
What did you just do? Okay, I'll tell everyone for you. So Jerry walked into a store. What time is it right now, Dee Dee?
Like 6:30.
6:30. Okay, he walked in and he said, "Ohio." And then the shopkeeper, like, he responded.
He responded, "Ohio."
With Ohio.
Ohio.
He responded saying, "Ohio." Good job.
I'm not Japanese.
Of course you're not. Baka Gaijin this show.
If this was Taiwan, I'd be making fun of you.
What? I mean, at least I know how to say good morning, you know?
You know how to say good evening, good afternoon?
Exactly. No, you don't.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
In Taiwan?
Yeah, in Taiwan. Okay, let's pretend we're in Taiwan right now.
Okay.
Hello.
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 Ding Tai Fong.
So stupid.
Ding Tai Fong. So
stupid. Ding Tai Fong, sure how. Well,
Ping. Boiling point.
Boy, so dumb.
Bao Jerry.
Xiao Pao. Chao King. Chao King. No, it's not.
It is.
Is it Chinese? But it's derived from Chinese people, right? Chao King. Xiao Pao.
Bao King.
Now we go to Cat Cafe.
Let's go.
Pet some cats.
Got a kimono for herself, dude. Oh my god. We didn't get anything.
Did we?
Oh my god, our weebs are showing like full on, dude. Look at Chris, full body shot.
Look at that shit, dude. Look at that shit, dude. Even with the dragon boots.
I know. Damn, BD. Yeah, everything is so tight. Look at Jerry. Man, look at the samurai. He even like borrowed a sword. Oh my god, what a freaking weeb. Oh my gosh, look at him, dude. And here at this exhibit, we have the ancient Japanese bathroom.
また降り出した夜空に舞う雪にあの日のこと
Alright Jerry, what are you gonna do?
Throw the sword down and stick some
in. Oh shit! You fucking weeb? What you got, Seattle? Ain't got nothing on this, dude.
Jerry-san!
Hi!
Hi!
Ohio!
Fuck you.
Oh, trash.
Oh,
okay.
Trash is these impossible. Are hard to find.
Thank yes, God. They are very hard to find.
I can't throw away everything.
All right, Jerry, your turn.
What?
Get in there.
What the fuck?
I'm just kidding. Wow.
I called you the samurai
dude. You don't have a sword anymore.
What the fuck? Dude, what are you talking about?
You don't have a sword anymore. Okay, I'm gonna get it. I swear, this guy's so horny, dude.
No, you're so horny.
Jesus Christ. All right, Didi, what'd you get?
I got a matcha mochi ball, dude.
Matcha mochi ball? Oh, sorry, stuff.
Hey.
I also got a daifuku mochi right here. What is this?
Oishii desu ne.
What are you guys doing? Yonda? Fucking weaves! Holy shit!
Oh my god! Fucking Didi! What the fuck? What are you doing?
Oh my god! What's going on? I'm embarrassed!
Oh my god!
Ah, shit, huh?
Tonghua,
you racist.
Put them, put
I, Pao Bu. Why don't we speak Tagalog? Like, we're not very good.
You sound Vietnamese, dog.
I don't know. Mada kono sekai wa boku o kai narashite tai mitai da nozomi dori daro.
Only 3,000 head of cattle qualify as authentic Kobe cattle each year.
Oh my god.
So out of billions of cows, we ate creme la creme. Top 3,000.
Yes, we did. Creme la creme, dude. The cream of the
crop, dude.
Yeah, I would eat 20 of those. I'm scared and excited for what's about to happen.
Shit.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back the feeling for so long. And if you feel like I feel, baby, then come on. Oh, come on. Woo! Let's get it on. There's just no words. No
we
words.
Ate in silence.
Come on and slam. Welcome to Come on and slam.
Didi's not in the mood to slam.
No, man. He don't want it to end. That's what you gotta say, Didi, to all the Japanese girls. You gotta say, you know what you're smelling right now, girl?
We about to get this man hooked up.
I know. Seriously.
Dude, I don't even think a girl can compare to this.
You heard it right here, dude.
I would just eat this meat instead of beating that meat. You feel me?
Whoever you end up dating, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I feel so bad for whoever you end up dating. It's like, sorry, girl. You just won't end up like this Kobe beef that you're eating right now. Everybody's separate now, so we got like, what? Ross goes to Davis. Diego goes, is trying to get a job in SF. Didi's in SF too. And then y'all are in the Bay Area.
The Bay?
The Bay?
Bay?
Bay, yeah.
Bay life?
Bay life, dude. And my ass is in LA, stuck there forever until I can live off of this. Until I can live off
of this.
look back at this video and be like, you made it.
Hopefully, fucking why. It's gonna take like 3 years for that shit, man.
I'm not concerned.
It's gonna take 3 years.
You'll get there.
Oh, man. Thanks, Jerry. That's very nice. Look at this, guys. Suge! This time on the Discovery Channel, Dead of Heads to Nijo Castle.
Alright.
This time, he must drink his own piss.
Okay, maybe not that.
Here at Nijo Castle, the ancient people of Japan must drink their own piss in order to survive, since food is very scarce.
No, they don't, dude. No.
Do you agree with this statement, Chris?
Hi.
Hi, so, what a beautiful day.
I see white people.
You see white people? Where? The indigenous white people of Japan. The gates of all gates. There it is. In ancient Japanese times, people tried to ram the gate, but admired it for its beauty. So with that, they didn't even try to touch it. Here we see the indigenous Japanese, here in the natural habitat, at Nijo Castle.
Did you call me Japanese?
Ichima! Here at Nijo Castle, they raise all the koi fish in one pond. Here they mate, and the lake is consisted of koi sperm. All they do is stick the females inside and harvest the babies and put them all around Japan. This here is Nijo Castle's sperm lake.
Shut up,
in
dude.
Japan.
In Japan.
In Japan.
Why are we listening to this song?
It's a piece of cake to bake a pretty cake.
If the way is hazy, you gotta do the cooking by the book.
You know you can't be lazy.
Never use a messy recipe.
The cake will end up crazy.
If you do cooking by the book,
then you'll have a cake.
here we go.
Today we're about to get our mouths graced with what I consider the best sushi.
Dude. Tell me about them strawberry, dude. What that strawberry do? Tell me what that strawberry do.
Dude, the strawberry tastes like fucking candy, man.
Oh my god. How much was it?
$15 for fucking 6 or 7 strawberries.
How the fuck do they do that?
I don't know.
This strawberry is incredible.
It's really the best.
I don't understand.
I don't get it. Japan, how do you do it?
It's freaking candy.
Hell yeah, dude.
You gotta get that lobster, man. Oh shit.
Yeah,
oh yeah!
I got you, bitch.
Go! Yay!
Nice catch.
Where are we, dude?
We're at the Sensoji Temple, that's where we are. Japan, you've been amazing. I'm so sad to go.
That's really sad, man.
Yeah, really sad, but it was a great trip.
It was a great trip,
right guys?
Yep.
Right, Chris?
That's
amazing.
Oh, man. 10 out of 10, 11 out of 10, 20 out of 10, 20 out of 100 out of 10. Would go again.
A million out of 10.
You thought Disneyland was happy?
Ichiman out of 10, dude.
Wow, Ichiman out of 10. Okay.
So, I just visited my teacher. There's a reason for that. A long time ago, in high school, I really wanted to go to Japan. And I guess I never took the subject that seriously. I learned a little bit, but it wasn't until I went to Irvine where I took it really seriously and I met a wonderful teacher. And she became my favorite teacher ever because she was the first teacher to ever care about, I guess, my education and I guess my overall well-being. And it really touched my heart that she cared that much about me. To explain the extent of what I'm talking about, a long time ago, there was this thing called the Kakahashi Project. What it was that it was a program that was funded by the military that sponsored a group of students to go to Japan, full ride. And in order to get into that program, you had to present a piece of American culture in Japanese. And so I chose to do American cinema and present that in Japanese, and I guess I did pretty well. I mean, I don't think I did pretty well, but it was enough that I got into the program. And so I was really happy. And because I was in this organization that required me to be in several places at once and required a lot of my time to represent the organization that I was in and that I couldn't attend the initial meetings, I was kicked out. And I mean, of course, that's not anyone's fault. That's just what I chose to get myself involved in. But I guess you guys knowing me and knowing how much of a weeb I am, throughout everything that you've seen, every single thing that I've edited for JK or like my content, I mean, like, and even though I call Julia a weeb all the time, you guys already know that that was pretty much like my dream, to go and experience that. I was devastated. I really was devastated at that time. I cried for like a week. I just remember hearing that news and falling into Lisa's arms like a K-drama and just going like, they kicked me out of the program, and I was really destroyed. Honestly, I think after that point, I failed to accept that I was actually getting really depressed. It didn't really hit me until, I guess, like maybe like a year later, that what could have been. So after I was rejected from the program and crying my eyes out, I went to class the next day, and usually I don't really show my feelings as much. Things happen. That's life. That's life. And I just, you know, store it in the back of my unconscious, and you know, I just didn't let it affect me as much, and I didn't know it was affecting me as much. And during the class, maybe my sensei saw something. It was the middle of class too, and we were doing partner reading, but she called me out of class. I remember she told me, she's like, "Byron, you work so hard every day, and I can see that in you, like, as my student, and I'm very, very proud of you for what you do in my class." That shit made me cry. Cried right there on the spot, because my sensei was the one person who, you know, believed in my abilities. There's hardly a time where you have that in your life and you're blessed to have someone who cares about you a lot, even when you're at like the worst of your worst. An opportunity like that is taken away from you, and I've always remembered her kindness towards me and how willing she was to believe in me, like, no matter what. So even though that's been a year and a half since I've seen my sensei, it made me really happy to go and visit her today. We scheduled a meeting, we're gonna like meet once a week and we're gonna practice Japanese together, and it's really gonna be fun. I'm happy that there's someone like that in my life who just cares that much. So I'm very, very grateful to have went to Japan the way that I did and spend it with my best friends and to utilize all the Japanese that my sensei taught me. I think that from now on, like, I'm just gonna study like the hardest that I ever did and trying to become better at the subject, because I'm forever grateful that she will be there for me throughout my life. That's the Japan trip. Vlogs can only tell you so much about what I'm experiencing, but to me, that was the most life-changing trip of my entire life and the most fun I've ever had, ever. And it means so much more that I've waited this long to experience something like that. So thanks for watching these vlogs. I'm looking forward to the next trip that I'll have. Even though that it won't be as great as Japan, but I wanted to tell you that story because it really meant a lot to me. And it meant more than just, you know, all the sights that we saw that day or those 13 days that we were in Japan. So, domo arigato gozaimasu. Thank you very much for watching. もう少しだけでいい。あと少しだけでいい。もう少しだけでいいから。